Hello and welcome to Current in the Afternoon. Woo! We got some new faces here. Happy to see you all. We have some old faces.
Yeah.
I don't know. I got a pretty old face. I told my husband today, I think I'm having a bad face day.
How are you?
So hopefully my face will improve. So, Rocky Number. Michael Goldner, let's do this lineup before I forget. I didn't do it. This is so, I feel like I'm being interrogated. Can you ask me to turn it to me? Okay, so Michael Goldner, you'll be after me, and then we'll have Bill.
Yeah.
Bill, you'll be second.
Okay.
Okay, so
I'll go third.
Who's third?
Ronald.
Ronald the Rondini.
Ronald Rondini, that's right. That's me.
Two is Bill Wheeler.
How are you feeling?
And we have three.
Over
the,
oh, yeah.
Woo! That's a Rondini. Can you see me still?
Longer than I thought, but it looks so bad.
I'm sorry, what?
You can barely see me. I'll ask Steve when he comes in if you can see me on the camera. So Ronald, and then we have Paul. Did you come in with Bill?
We have two Pauls.
He was here before I was here.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, okay, so you can go after Ronald. How's that?
Yeah.
Okay. And you want to be seven, right?
I don't care. It doesn't matter.
Okay, let me put you four then. I think I heard you say something like that. So Rocky will be number four, and then five will be Paul Lear. And then we have Leslie. Yes. Okay. Leslie's number six.
An old face.
Okay, and then, what's your name?
My name's John, a listener.
You're a listener. Okay, John. Okay, and then...
But Deidre is here.
I see her.
Yeah.
I see
Deidre.
Her. Deidre. Deidre is here. Okay, so then we have Paul Stevenson, correct?
Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
I got it. You all have two. He's just got he has an act. He has an actual act. So everybody, you can do two songs, and then I think that anyone else who comes in, we may start them with one. So the band. Oh, band naming. Okay, so I'm going to give everybody a little piece of paper, and I know some of you have sent in names. Name submissions. For those who don't know what I'm talking about, we're having a contest to name the band. The band, I think after today, or maybe in a couple of days, give people more of a chance, although we do have about 15 names.
About the Beatles.
Well, you have to write that down. I'm going to give you a slip of paper.
Genius. I didn't understand.
You write down
genius
the name.
Genius idea.
How about the Rolling Stones?
You write down the name you're suggesting and your name, and then the band is going to vote.
Okay, I'll do it.
The band's going to pick out their own name. And then if you win, you'll get three songs, a little three-song mini set. Or if it was something like Ron, it would be like 15 minutes. You get 15 minutes. So,
when will it be announced, the name?
I will announce it after the band picks out the name. And if the band doesn't like any of the names, then they're going to name themselves and nobody wins out. So, because that'd be fair. I mean, if they're all just terrible, terrible names, you can't expect them to say, well, okay, we'll take this one. So then they need to name themselves. So that's the contest. And so for all you viewers at home, you're welcome to email me at ALICIADESO at SBCGlobal.com. Did you get that? Anyway, or you can email me. Okay, get a room.
I know, we haven't seen each other since 6:30 this morning.
Oh my goodness, look at you. They're love bugs, aren't they? They were smooching. And we could probably hear it on the camera. We could probably hear that. Anyway, because when you're sitting next to the camera, we do hear things.
Okay, so we'll try.
We hear like gossip. We hear a lot. Anyway, so did I get everybody? Do I have everybody? I got Michael Goldner, Will Wheeler, Ronald, Rafi, Paul Weir, Leslie Thorson, Paul Stevenson, Deirdre Monsi. Anybody? Did I miss anybody?
Matt.
Oh, we never miss Matt. And by the way, we had a Zoom. Last night, our weekly Sunday Zoom, and I played your song for them.
The Voodoo.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And they were so happy to see it.
Oh, thank you so much.
You're welcome. I really like it. It's very catchy. Have you listened to his song, The Voodoo? Because it's very catchy. There you go. All right. For those of you at home, it's mattbunsen.com, and you can find The Voodoo, his latest single, on YouTube.
Yeah.
Alright, so the band is going to play a song, and Garland's going to introduce that, and then I'll do a song, and then we'll hear from the charming and handsome Mr. Michael Goldner. Alright, so, and at the end of all that, after Deirdre, we'll have Matt up. Alright?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so go ahead, band!
Good evening and peace and blessings, everybody. We've got some new people included in the afternoon. My name is Mr. Garland Jackson, and I am from the Crenshaw District of Los Angeles.
Yeah.
I'm going to do something a little special for everybody. This is a young lady that I befriended about 20 years ago. And I'll just give out her first name only. Her name is Zucari, and she wrote this for me in the year of 2022. And this is a little bit of a E minor type of slow blues, and the name of this piece is an original blues. It's entitled Dear Mr. and Mrs. Jackson, and they were the ones that raised me right to study and learn how to play the tenor saxophone. I hope you all like it. Could I get just a tad more light, please, if possible?
Ask this gentleman. Is there any more light?
Just a little bit more for me, please. Thank you. Logic. When I came to you, I wrecked me, and I had wrecked you, and I had wrecked you. So much, so many, all the good, stuff I either destroyed, broke, ruined, or burned. Understand I have no excuse except I was raised in abandonment and abuse. Didn't know I was too fit by ins and your outs, by credentials to your doubts. I've lost the keeper of my heart by disputed flats. Best God won't I ever get some rest. Sorry, I can't even say I would be better if I tried, but God is my witness, amen for that, I would do or die. I don't want to live without you. I don't deserve to be so blue. It's a tricky situation, an uncertain destination. Thank you. I'm going to take it home, y'all.
Gave myself in that misty light.
eyes by a strange light under a lilac tree. I made wine from a lilac tree, put my heart in the recipe. Makes me see what I want to see and be what I want to be. When I think more than I ought to think, do things I never should do, I drink much more than I ought to drink, because it brings me back you.
We should read our names so that we can all hear them.
Well, I thought that they might be better off with blind voting. Not because what if it's a song, a name from someone they don't like? Oh, see, now you're cheating. cheating.
Cheating?
Mister?
What else? What other way is
there? Anonymous.
I think so.
Oh, it's not anonymous. It's asked
for your... Look at that. I can see. I'll be the one letting you know.
So, Arlisha, are you going to read them all out, though, out loud?
I'm not
going to. So
we
can all hear?
I think we should.
Well, then I have to go through my emails, too. And read the ones that were emailed to me.
I see.
Right.
Well,
we heard the Beatles. That's
well, you know,
what?
That's why I draw more people.
And you
know,
it
all read
out.
What
the we like it small.
Because
we'll take a bath.
All right.
I'm sorry, we draw the
list. I'm going to have them do it on their own. So, they're too.
We write in our own.
The concern is that these, even if you're.
Any time today, Mike.
California ballot today.
Yeah, two songs.
Hold on.
Any
time today. They didn't even put the thing in the jar yet.
Okay.
With a lot of pages.
There's some real genius ideas going in, and it would be
that's
nice,
right.
even if they don't get picked, to know.
Have them recognize.
Like the Garland Festival.
All right, I'll tell you what.
Mike Cutter. The Garland Festival.
Do you have a Mike Cutter?
Yes, I do.
He does. He's getting it out. That's all right, so I'll tell you what.
What
are the girls
want?
Foreskins is a great one. Really.
El shit show. He said it was a shit show.
The Flaccid Boys.
Okay. So I was going to say foreskins, but.
The foreskins. There
you go.
There we go. Now the juices are flowing.
That's
appropriate because I want to do a little tribute to Richard Lewis, who died the other day. I have to ask his therapist. So I met him at an art opening over in Hollywood once, and someone said, "Hey, you're late, Richard." He goes, "Hey, I had to park in El Segundo." But he said, "Why were you late?" He goes, "I was at my exercise class. Me and a group of Jews get together in the park and we do our self-defense exercises. Why me? Why me?" Is that anti-Semitic? I don't know. Is anti-Semitism, can it be funny? Did you see Schindler's List? It was too long. The movie? No, the list. That's a little out there.
Oh.
Anyway, Richard Lewis, I loved his joke about his going to therapy because of his mother. He doesn't know it. He says he's backstage at the Tonight Show and she calls him. He says, Mom, I'm on the Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. She says, who else is on?
That's right.
I can identify. When I was in therapy, my therapist, my mother, that's a Freudian slip. Freud thought dreams were one of the roads to the unconscious, and he thought slips of the tongue were another. But my therapist asked me, when was I the happiest as a child? I called my mom, and she said, you know, when you had that paper route when you were a kid, and that was the first time people used to come up to me and say, is this your son? He is so wonderful. He puts the paper right where we want it, and we actually look forward to him coming around when he collects. And my mom, there was a pause, and she said, you know, maybe you could get that paper route back. Anyway, I was in therapy for many years, and I used to go up in this elevator and sit in the waiting room and read the New Yorker, and then my time would come up and I'd go in and rant and rave and share my most innermost fears and hopes and dreams. And after a few years, I decided it was time for some action. I got a subscription to the New Yorker. That was the action. We're gonna do 16 tons. You know that one, right?
Yeah.
Every week. You know that one, right?
Yeah.
You know that one. Okay, let's try it. In E flat. Let's see. Oh, so.
Some folks say a man is made out of mud, the poor man's made out of muscle and blood. It's a sing-along, folks. Muscle and blood, skin and bone, a mind that's weak, but a back that's strong. He pulled 16 tons, and what did he get? I had another day older and deeper in debt. Say, Peter, don't you call me, because I can go.
That's a valid one, too.
All right, so here comes Mr. Bill Wheeler. Did you get both of your instructions for your two songs?
I only
have
one song.
He only has one song. Oh, my
it's
goodness.
Long.
Oh, it's a long song. I'm throwing off my timing. All right, everybody. Here he is. The man we worship, the man we adore, Mr. Bill Wheeler. He has his own mic coming. Yay!
I've been working on this song for a long time. Every chance I can get, I'm doing it again. I think I may finally have it down. I knew a man, Bojangles, he would dance for you in his worn-out shoes, silver hair, ragged shirt and baggy pants. He would do the old top shoe. He could jump so high, jump so high. Then he lightly jumped. Thank you. pen in a cell in New Orleans. I was down and out. He seemed to have the very eyes of age. As he spoke right out, he talked of life, talked of life, laughed and slapped his knee and lightly stepped around. He said his name, Bojangles, and he danced a little right across the cell. Hitched up his pants, took a belly stance, then he jumped so high. That's when he clicked his heels. Let go alive, let go alive. Shook back his clothes all around. That was Mr. Bojangles. Mr. Bojangles. Mr. Bojangles, he could dance. He used to do the shows, the minstrel shows in county fairs, all throughout the South. He spoke with tears of the 15 years with his dog and he. They would travel about. Well, his dog up and died. His old dog up and died. After 20 years, he still said now I dance at every chance in honky tonks. For my drinks and tips, but most of the time I spend behind these county bars. You see, so I drinks a bit. I heard somebody say, hey, hey, that's Mr. Bojangles.
Yeah.
It's Mr. Bojangles. Oh, Mr. Bojangles, could you please dance?
What's happening?
Man, thank you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, Bill Wheeler. You know, that could, the only way that would have been better is if Rocky came up and did a sock shoe.
I can't do that.
Yeah, I bet.
I actually was thought about doing the sock.
Oh, wow. So, next up, we have a different kind of act here. Now, Mr. Ron Daney, do you need the band?
No, they can watch, though.
Okay. Let's not put that so far back that we can't get it back again. Maybe just right here. Okay, so band, do you need all this space? How much space do you need?
Yeah, I don't need the microphones.
Okay, we'll move this down.
Push this up.
And does the band need to move or not?
No, I don't know.
Okay, so we'll just put this here.
Okay, I'm ready.
You're ready, all right. So maybe I'll just rest this here. What'd you say, you don't need an introduction?
I'm waiting
for it. Oh, how about an introduction? Okay, so everyone's running things today.
Yeah,
this is a newcomer to Crew in the Afternoon. It is the great Ron Daney.
Thank you.
Put it on with your mouth.
It's definitely too small. According to my daughter. Hold on. It's my phone. I apologize. Oh, it's my wife. Hold on. Yes, honey boo-boo. Yes. Look, I told her I'm doing a show. For the mamacita. Thank you. Thanks. That was my wife, by the way. She told me, I can get my hand in my pocket. She told me what card you guys were going to pick. So here's the deal. She told me what card to turn over in the deck. You guys are going to pick a card, and let's see if we can make some kind of psychic connection. So hold on a second. I'm turning over a card in the deck. Hey. All right. Thank you for the music.
That was great.
You're going to come to my next gig, okay? All right. Give me a number 1 to 10.
8.
Clubs, hearts, spades, or diamonds?
Spades.
Spades? 8. Spades. If I can get the cards out. All right. So again, there's one card over. You pick the 8 of spades. Was it the 8 of spades?
Yeah.
After my wife told me what to turn on. And if I can do this, would that be a big round of applause? Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you. Now you might say to me, Ronald, Rondini.
Rondini.
I'm
saying it.
Oh, all right, so I'm going to go by Rondini then. Thank you very much. But you might say to me, Rondini, what kind of crummy magic trick is that? Your wife told you what the card was going to be. So I have to prove to you today that yes, in fact, I can do a card trick. And I deserve to be in the Magic Castle. And I can do a trick without the help of my wife. By the way, 40 years, ladies and gentlemen.
Woo-hoo!
Best 10 years of my life. Hey-o! All right, I'm going to peel off some cards. Young lady, I want you to tell me when to stop. Eight of clubs. Okay, I know it. I have to find it in a magic way. I can turn that card blue. So if I can turn that card blue, I really deserve to be a magician. Those magicians can't reject me much longer. So let's see if I can turn that card blue. Oh, hey. Look. Oh, wait. A blue card in an entire deck of red cards. Now, if in fact that card is the Eight of Clubs, that would be amazing. Hush falls over the crowd. Yeah, in anticipation, the blue card. Eight of clubs, ladies and gentlemen. Me and my family, you all may be not lucky.
What happened to the 8 of spades?
a second. Oh, you're still working on the last trick? Good job. All right, so tell me when to stop. I'm going to do it again, just in case you missed it. Ready?
Stop.
Two of diamonds. Can I turn the blue of diamonds, the two of diamonds blue, not the blue of diamonds. The two of diamonds, do we have anybody see? Anybody see a blue bar? Blue, two of diamonds. It's over here.
Whoa! What the heck?
And for my final endeavor, one of the things that we learn in the Magic Castle is how to implant things into people's brains. We can influence people in very many strange ways. And one of the main influencers is color. Yeah. Keep it going. Influencing. All right. So, I have four colors here. I got green. Some people might think green is money, growth. Blue, mellow. Red. Sexy. Yeah? No? Maybe? All right, sexy red. All right, yellow. Intelligence. So, let's start with this gentleman here. What do you do for a living besides hanging out here?
I'm an artist. Artist.
What kind of art do you perform?
Printmaking, painting, drawing.
Man, I am impressed. Okay, I kind of know what you're going to pick in advance. Which color speaks to you?
I'd say green.
Red?
Green.
Oh, man, here, I thought you were going for the sexy. All right, take that little green card out, but don't, just to see the little green card, take it out, but don't look at it until I tell you to. So let's go to a lady. What do you do for a living? You're a lady of leisure. Let's just leave it at that. Okay, pick one. Which color speaks to you?
Well, here, he got the green already. I'll take the yellow.
That's because you're smart. Right? You look
cowardly.
All right. I knew you were going to pick that, by the way. I knew it in advance before I even walked in the door. So we got green, we got yellow, we got one left. I didn't pick you yet, did I? What do you do for a living, sir?
Nurse.
Very good. I respect nurses. They're the best people. They make pretty good money these days, don't they? Yeah, I thought so. Now, whatever you pick, I'm going to be left with the other one. Sexy. Calm. Sexy.
Sexy.
Sexy. Yeah, let's hear it for the... Watch out for him, girls. That's after the sexy thing. Now, that leaves me with blue... You know what? I'm going to let you hold mine absolutely. So people don't think.
Sure.
Oh, wait. Let's put this down. I was left with blue, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Who's the first person that I pick? Yeah. Read your card out loud so everyone can hear it.
I will pick green.
That is right. You're second. All right. Read your card. I knew you.
Phoebe.
I will pick yellow.
I knew you would pick yellow.
Wow.
And the third was here.
I will pick red.
Ta-da!
Wow.
Yeah. Okay, that was sympathy. All right, do me a favor.
Sure.
One card left. Just read the top line on that card.
Consider it done. The man will pick green.
And the next line.
Next line. The woman will pick yellow.
And the next line. Oh.
The person with glasses will pick red.
Final line. Hey. Final.
The final one will be, I will be left with blue.
Yeah!
Thank you.
I'm close.
Get us all in.
No, I'm close.
You gotta have like a croon night at the Magic Castle.
Yeah.
So, so you know, it's time for the old soft shoe man.
Right.
Yeah.
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 Walk right out of the room.
He
knows something. He knows something.
Okay, so while they're doing all of that, Deirdre, why don't you, Deirdre, why don't you tell us about your show?
Well, I'm going to be doing a show at the Gardenia on Thursday, April 25th.
Sure.
One of my besties, Kevin Ray, who lives in New York City, is going to be a special guest. He's an incredible, prolific singer-songwriter and wrote an award-winning musical that won a bunch of awards in New York. And he's going to be sitting in with me, and it's going to be super fun. I'm going to be doing an album release of six original songs, as well as some cover tunes. So it's going to be really fun.
I'll be there.
And Paul's coming. Are you in the audience?
I'll be the audience.
Yeah. All right, Paul. We're going to see Paul.
Yeah, he's trying to pull a little bit of a Lucy. He's trying to get in the big show. But for now, he's just going to be audience.
Ricky! We'll be in the show. All right, so.
7 to 10 p.m.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Don't get up. This is really kind of weird. I don't know how to explain this. I'm planning on wearing this shirt tonight, but I put it on and I reached into the pocket and there's a piece of paper in there that says, I will follow the magician.
All right. Yeah. Excellent, boy.
First I'm going to do stop at the groom. A piece of prose to the tree, and then I'll sing a song. Both are pretty short. This one is called Son of Grace and Ralph. That wasn't their true names, Graciela and Raffaele, but Americanization and prejudice made the alterations immigrants with assimilation. What do we have here? Freedom. There are rights. Here we have rights. Ralph connived a way for them to meet. Sitting in the middle of the steps on the stoop, she couldn't get down without asking politely for him to move. Gracious grace overwhelmed him. Love blinded his reason, but it settled into a courtship that had wings and music. Music was the opera. He knew a guy, so he could sneak her into the Metropolitan Opera, fourth row. Had to pay for Broadway musicals, so. Come home with the glow and the album. Dancing, big band, ragtime, Charleston, Neapolitan love songs. Later on, Bing Crosby, Louis Armstrong, and Louis Jordan, Irving Berlin, and country too. Nobody ever mentioned genres. Ride the American magic carpet of opportunity. A true partnership of practical dedication, hard work, faith, and extended family. More love and laughter. Odd jobs to pay for extended education to find their niche. Plenty of gourmet food to sustain the two jobs each worked every day. Grace, a genius in the kitchen, and solid and reliable and upbeat at work. Orderly and wise, tough, gracious and kind. By example, taught kindness, kindness, kindness to us, and consoling when prejudice struck, physical maladies, accident or medical struck. By example, Ralph taught respect. By example, all deserve it. You don't know what they're going through. Keep moving up the economic ladder toward a better life for the children. Sunday family dinners, 4 to 5 hours of three generations of families laughing in sumptuous delights. Right from wrong, they knew what we had to know. Discipline, when called for, came from frustration, from the frustration. I'm not sure to act or react. They were only human. It ended quickly, and later, together, they would reevaluate those in-the-moment reactions calmly, intelligently. A bastion of support for children soaring. Be a doctor with all our might. Support, scrimp, save, make contacts. Be an actor? Dad, in confidence. He had to pick the ones you feel that I don't know how to help him. sister, newlywed now. They need a car. Drive this one to them. Core family, extended family. This core did not exist. Not at the home of Grace and Ralph. Mm-hmm. All right. And it goes. Let me sing a funny song with crazy words that roll along. And if that song gets starts in laughing, I'm happy, happy. Let me sing a sad refrain of broken hearts that loved in vain. And if that song can start you crying, I'm happy. Ooh, let me sing a low-down blues that gets you out of your seat. And if those blues get into your shoes and start to tapping your feet,
begin with the way I describe him to anybody who asks me about him.
He's the kid that at the age of 14 got kicked off the school bus in front of the topless bar and had to go inside and get a ride home. he always has cats. We always had cats when I was little. We never had dogs, just cats. We had a cat that had serial kittens, one litter after another. In retrospect, it was really almost immoral of us to let that cat do that. But at any rate, when I was in college, he had this black cat named Jasper. And I had purchased a yellow beanbag chair for my dorm room. When I came home from the summer, I brought it home and put it beside my bed in my bedroom. And Jasper proceeded to continually leave his calling card upon it. And we finally figured out that the texture of the beanbag chair was that of a litter box.
Oh, no.
So he was probably thinking to himself, you know, what's the upgrade? So we disposed of that, and I don't think I ever got another one. Probably 15 years ago, my brother had a cat named Leo, orange striped cat, beautiful. My brother lives in Pennsylvania on a creek. In the winter, when the snows melt, the creek rises, it gets cold, it freezes. For some reason, he allowed Leo to be indoor and outdoor. And one night, they heard this horrendous screech, feline screech, and they heard the ice break. And he didn't come home. And we all mourned him. I mourned him from the distance of here. And it wasn't too long after that that his wife was sitting watching TV, and she looked over, and from underneath this chair was this orange striped tail going back and forth. And it was him. He found his way back into the house. Prior to that, my mother lived in Philadelphia, and he didn't make a lot of money. He had a cat at that time that became ill, and he took the cat up to the University of Pennsylvania Veterinary School, and they diagnosed it with a heart condition, and they gave him a price, and he wasn't able to meet the price. So he was bereft, he was crying, he said goodbye to the cat, and he left. About a week later, they called and said, hey, come get your cat. We were so upset by your reaction to losing him that we treated him. But now he's ready to go home, so please come get him. And he did, and the cat made it for another couple of years. So, at any rate, those are a few familial stories, and maybe I'll think of more and write them down. Thank you. Yeah.
Whoa, kitties! Who doesn't love kitties?
You shared the one in the house.
We have three.
Birds don't like them.
Birds don't like them. Bugs don't like them. You know, on our Zoom last night, I sang a song about cats. I know my cats, I know they didn't like it because it's actually Larry told me about this song. It was in Dr. No. You know, when I told everybody that Dr. No didn't have a theme song, you know, like a Dr. No theme song, Larry said, well, but there was a Calypso song in there. So I found it, and it's it goes three blind mice. Three blind mice. There they go. Three blind mice in a row. See how they run. Ta-da. Something like that. Then it goes, they all chase after the cat. Oh, ding. I can't go up that high. Ding. Can you go ding? Can you go with your They all chase after the cat. Hold on a second, Leslie. You remember this from last night. Okay. They all chased after the cat that swallowed the rat. Da 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 da. Three blind mice. And then the next verse was, they all chased, oh no, what did they do? They found the knife. Knife! And why did they knife? Excuse me. knifed the cat because the cat that trifled with the rat. You cannot trifle with a rat, especially if you've got three blind mice. And, you know, maybe I'm going to look this up in a bit and go on my husband's phone because mine's up there. All right, Leslie, she loves cats too.
Thank you. If I'm patient, the break will mend. And one fine morning, the hurt will end. So make the moments fly. Autumn, winter, I'll forget you by. Next year, some year. Though it's hell that I'm going through. Some Tuesday, Thursday, April, August, autumn, winter, next year, summer. Time heals everything. Time heals everything. But
I just we have noisemakers here. We have little things. Do you want to use? Do you want an egg? Do you want to use an egg? You can use an egg. Who wants to use an egg? We have two more eggs, and we have a gourd. Well, you were holding the gourd. It's a little metal one. You don't have a mic cover? Okay, we'll pass you one.
I have an extra one if you need one, Paul.
Okay, so after Paul is Leslie. I'm sorry. After Paul is Deirdre. After Deirdre, we have Larry Davis. No, we have Tom Tucker. No, we have Matt Bunsen. Matt Bunsen, then we have Tom Tucker, then we have Larry Davis, and then we have Tom Michelle. Everyone. So, you got a crowd here. You're going to get into the Magic Castle for sure.
Hopefully.
And so will we, because he's inviting us all.
I'm working on it.
He's working on it.
He's going to give you a little melody and then.
Are you a magician?
Okay. Huh?
You missed his act, he did it.
Yeah, you missed my whole man.
Sorry.
All right. Isn't that sweet how she's taking care of him? She's his roadie, everybody. Okay, here he is, Mr. Paul Stevenson.
Hi, everybody.
I can
so
see
you, baby. Be here. Yeah. See you all. This is a brilliant band behind us.
With us. What do you want to call them, Paul?
I can announce my choice.
It's called Baked Steel.
Yeah, this is Baked Steel. Or
okay.
A little slower than that. It's a little fast.
Go ahead and sing the melody and all.
So your hometown's bringing you down. Are you drowning in the small talk and the chatter? You're gonna step into line like your daddy done, punching the time and climbing life's long ladder.
Woo! Baby!
You've been howling at the moon like a slack-jawed fool and breaking every rule they can throw on. But one of these days is gonna be right soon. You'll find your legs and go and stay gone. Young man full of big plans and thinking about tomorrow. Young man, gonna make a stand. You beg, you steal, you borrow. You beg, you steal, you borrow. With all your friends that you knew in school, they used to be so cool, now they just bore you. But look at them now, they're already pulling the plow, so quick to take to grain like some old mule. And thinking about tomorrow. Young man, gonna make a stand. You beg, you steal, you borrow. You beg, you steal, you borrow. Thank you. girl and go when no one knows you? What will all the old folks say? So your hometown's bringing you down. Are you drowning in the small talk and the chatter? Are you gonna step in the line like your daddy done? Punching the time and climbing life's long ladder. Young man, full of big plans and thinking about tomorrow. Young man, gonna make a stand. You beg, you steal, you borrow. You beg, you steal, you borrow.
There is actually, if you keep on flipping through that book, then it should be the next page. Just flip to the next page, it'll be there. In just tab form, like.
Okay. All right, let's get this one going. We don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee. We don't take our trips on LSD. We don't burn our draft cards down on Main Street. We like living right and being free. I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee, a place where even squares can have fun. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse, and white light then still the biggest thrill of all. We don't make a party out of loving. We like holding hands and pitching wool. We don't let our hair grow long and shaggy like the hippies out in San Francisco do. I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee, a place where even the squares can have a ball. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse, a white light and still the biggest thrill of all. Leather boots are still in style, maybe footwear. Beads and Roman sandals won't be seen. And football's still the roughest thing on campus. And the kids here still respect the college dean. I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee, place where even squares can have a ball. We still revel glory down at the courthouse. And white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. I'm a Muskogee in Muskogee, in Muskogee, Oklahoma, USA.
Galveston. She said she was from Galveston. Oh, this is a whole story, but she said, I hate Oklahoma. And I was like, well, what are you doing here? I'm getting my sister.
Okay.
And she was living in this cat house. It was a cat house. I mean, you know, not a, you know, cat house. It was like, you know, meow. Cats everywhere. And there were dogs out front. Dogs tied up and cats all around the house. It's a long story. You know what? I should tell it some other time because it's worth telling, but she hates Oklahoma. And then, you know, later we went to a fruit stand or a vegetable stand somewhere. It was a farm stand. And there was this very toothless woman who was talking to us, well, she who worked there. And she was telling me all about how she didn't have any power anymore and something about her back door. And someone came in her back door and there was no power. And she, you know what she said to me? She said, I hate Oklahoma. And I was like, oh, well, it seems to be something going on. Thank you. I have three of them. Shake and touch it. This one's green.
This one probably can get a wish, you know?
Yeah. I have a green. This is a green one. I have a black one and I have a red one. And then I have a black scarf to go with the black hat, and I have a red scarf to go with the red hat. And I mix and match.
That's good to know.
Because who doesn't want to do matchy-matchy? Yeah.
Matchy-matchy all the time.
All right. So you know what? It's Deirdre and Monty. I'm, you know, whenever I see your name, you know, first it runs through as Deirdre, but I'm like, I'm really trying so hard to say Deirdre.
It's okay. I've grown up with all kinds of versions of my name.
I know, but everybody gets my name wrong, so I want to get your name right.
Good.
I even have a teacher. I have a teacher, a first grade teacher. You can tell I've been drinking coffee. I think they gave us caffeinated coffee. And she calls me Miss Alicia, and she says to all the kids, okay, say goodbye to Miss Alicia. Or Miss Alicia's here, so they're all like, hi, Miss Alicia. You know. Okay. So we're going to have to train them when they get to third grade. It's Deirdre Muncy.
Thank you. We went to see an amazing concert the other night at the Disney Concert Hall, and it was an evening of organ music. And Paul and I had never seen just an evening of concert of organ music, and the gentleman was fantastic. And for his encore, he played this song, which I've never tried to sing, but I was so inspired. So nice and slow to start. Please. There's a saying old, says that love is blind. Still I'm often told, seek and ye shall so I'm going to seek a certain lad I've had in my mind. Looking everywhere, haven't found him yet. He's the big affair.
Switch
yeah.
Mics?
Yes.
We are.
Thank you for your patience, guys. It's a quick little setup.
Hurry up.
Hurry up.
In your arms.
this feeling lasts for the rest of my life.
Sing the chorus, drown, down a shot of whiskey, and
crank up Johnny Cash, you will sing after me. Down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash.
Yeah.
All right, we got this.
One, two, three. I never hopped a freight train or danced with Cajun queens. I never thumbed a diesel down or been to New Orleans. Here's one place I wanna go, I do it in a flash. I down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. Sing it out now. Down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. I never lost a fortune. All the dice. I've been to Vegas a couple times, but I never paid full price. But here's one wager you can lose to hang on to your stash. It's down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. Down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. Woo! I never met the devil, but I'm hoping that he's real. It's time for fame and fortune, come on, let's make a deal. Hold on, what would Jesus do? He would not be so rash. Down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. Down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. I'm lucky with the ladies, some nights I just can't lose. I'd like to take a whole bunch home, or how's a man to choose? Who you wanna be my girl, just complete this task. It's down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. Come on! Down a shot of whiskey and crank up Johnny Cash. Take my break.
Very nice. Songs I've never heard by people I've never heard. heard.
It's a Randy Newman song.
I've heard of it, but I've never heard it
listening.
Oh,
to
I've
her.
Got a lot of versions of it.
On her version?
Yeah.
It's dead.
No, what happened to my mic?
What happened?
Step quick, step on the green mark.
Yeah.
It's done.
Put your jokes together three times.
Be crazy. Don't be
no.
Okay.
Huh.
It's
my
eyes.
Must be unplugged.
When she loved me, it's such a great song.
Yeah. Here you go. Let's see what I'm going to do.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Did you see Bonnie Raitt at the Green Theater? I did, not last summer, just in September. It was amazing. I cried, like, uncomfortably, I'm sure, almost with people around me so many times. It was an exquisite concert.
It was right to your heart.
You could hear a pin drop when she's singing Angel from Montgomery. Because she's jumped kind of fast.
And I can't make you love me.
Oh,
here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Tom Tucker!
Thank you.
Charming.
Yeah. Incomparable, and you're not happy with it.
Oh, does he? Well, yeah, he's pretty incomparable.
Except the first time she introduced him, she said, she can't remember the word, she said, the comparable.
and we're comparing him right now.
That has never been done.
So here he is. He's going to do something special because he always does it. Mr. Larry Davis.
I don't know where this, what this is from, but it's a haunting song. He was too good to me. How can I get along now? So close he stood to me. Everything gone so wrong now. He would have brought me the sun, making me smile. That was his fun. When I was mean to him, he'd never say, go away now. I was a king to him. Who's gonna keep me gay now? It's only natural. I'm so blue.
You're married too.
And next week's the big reveal.
All right.
Yes. For what? The name?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. We'll see how long it takes him to pick it.
Okay.
All right, so.
I want the list. I want to see what ideas everyone has.
He wants the list. All right,
public
Mr. Tom
ideas.
Michelle, everybody. Are you ready? All right, here they go. Tom, Michelle, and the band.
Yeah.
I'm going to take you back to the early 70s.
And when I go away, I know my heart can stay with my love. It's understood. It's everywhere with my love. My love does it good. It's understood. It's in the hands of my love. And my love does it good.
By the time he gets Phoenix, he did Galveston.
Okay.
But him not doing Wichita Lineman is like
a travesty.
It's like the Eagles not doing Hotel California.
Why don't you demand your money back?
A lot of people were like sighing at the end, like, he referenced it throughout the show.
He does. Started
saying,
"You should have done it."
Larry, what was the name of your song?
He was too good to me.
He was too good to me. I'm wondering if the man who's too good to me could write that down for me. Could you write down? He was too good to me.
I think she's talking to you, Steve.
So.
I saw Hall & Oates at the Hollywood Bowl, and they didn't play
Bridge.
All right,
so I'm going to do a song that we
and the audience lost it. Even the opera and the entire stadium on the way out was singing Rich Girl.
That takes guts.
Yeah.
It takes guts to get up here and sing a song about a drummer. All right, so are we ready? So I'm hoping that y'all can come back next week.
Yeah.
And I want to thank, well, we had a magician. He's gone. He just disappeared. I guess that's part of his act. I want to thank our audience member. Thank you for coming. And if you would like to give me your email address, I can put you on my mailing list.
Okay.
And then you always know what's happening. And I know we've announced this a couple of times, but Deirdre, what is the date of your show? April?
April 25th, Thursday.
Right. April 25th.
7 to 10 p.m.
All right, everybody. So thank you so much for coming. And and Leslie has a Zoom on Wednesday night, if you're ever interested in a Zoom.
A Zoom.
All right. So if you need to talk to anybody, please do it outside, because we need to clear the room for the next whatever it is that they find.
GTFO.
Thank you,
Rocky. On TikTok? Because we don't have any. Most of these people don't have TikTok. You know, most of the people here.
I think that people have some more viewers than they have on YouTube.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'm right.